Survival is important. We hunt to kill, but nature hunts us to kill too.
I meant that.
You get stuck out in the bush and you had to stay warm. Say, what would you do?
Hey man, a man's gotta live off the land, you know?
Right.
You gotta be prepared to wrap yourselves in plastic, wrap together, and share the warmth. You know, hey, two bodies pressed together, you know, it's cold,
Spoon,
you do what you gotta do.
Or as an alternative to that, you know, you just bring some gasoline, set some on fire.
Yeah. You know what? That's it. Burn shit is great.
Hell yeah.
Fuck, burn people too. I don't care. That's how we want none. Any scrub of bars should do it, really.
So that's it. Everything you need for a successful trip into the wilderness.
Yep.
We got boats, ocean poles, high quality ordnance, beer.
Yeah, beer.
We got more beer.
Yeah. And a buddy. Don't forget a buddy.
Yeah, you had yourself a good old time.
You know, some Indian tribes have beauty contests where the female contestants have to kill and slaughter a sheep. Superwoman, all covered in blood and sinew. What I'm saying is, they're all rat bitches anyway.
Yeah, amen to that. Amen. Now that was this week's You and Your Boat. You're listening to Bait and Switch with me, Larry Joe, my co-host, Bobby Wood.
No, wait. We're morning co-hosts, all right? We're buddies. I'd take a bullet for you.
What?
A big...
Thank you. Hero.
It's a shock that show was taken off the air so fast 40 years ago. But anyone with talent was storming normally. We'll have more from the archives of the Vice City Broadcasting System again soon. Next is New World Order, international news that takes you around the world and reaffirms you should stick to the safety of your planned subdivision. I love Florida. It's a gift to America. This is ACPR.
This is New World Order. I'm your host, Wayne Ford. I'm an American. Are you? If not, you don't deserve to own a radio. If, like me, you don't want a passport and consider Los Santos far too full of...
Thank you.
sponsorship.
Thank you. suggestion ring from a friend of mine. I really make love for 3 days without coming. I don't know what Aztec Jazz or Carl Jung is, but my kids shouldn't be exposed to it.
Well, all of this spawning leads to one thing. Unworkable economic systems. TV shows with 3 boys and 3 girls sharing a bathroom. In my house, where rich people live, we have 6 bathrooms per person, and only the men shower together. It's how we were raised. You know what happens when you have collective ownership? A man will come use your tractor and your wife. And I'm not just talking about baking biscuits, sweetheart. I'm talking about making sure that bun in your oven is yours.
What?
About owning the oven. About owning the whole bakery.
Listen, I know it's mine. I haven't even left the hospital bed for delivering a baby, and my husband is already on top of me, wanting a new one.
He's
a red-blooded American man with a full working penis. He says he's only attracted to me when I've got that motherless love.
I think you're all getting a little too personal. I'm just giving my opinion. I think you're getting a little too personal for this. Gestation's a lie. Science. You should hear what they're teaching young minds in science class in college. Homo superior, they're right.
Listen, education should be privatized. I don't care whose land we took. This is today. And it's simply not fair that I can't run bingo and sell tax-free cigarettes and clear love. All because of some hideous, puritanical streak in people. Religion has everything to answer.
Technology's my religion. For me, an electronic company is like the Bible. People used to try to understand the universe through things like parables and abstract ideas. Now I understand it completely with numbers. I can type things and turn the calculator upside down and spell words.
See,
sure. And I know for a fact that life is completely pointless and meaningless. If I have an imaginary friend, I think I'm home. Life is random. Religion is for me. I could be killed tomorrow.
Thank
this
God.
Woman right here could sit on me with her stomach and kill me.
I have a painful hemorrhoid.
Technology really saves a penny. Is religion pointless?
It's patriarchy. Calculators are a way of keeping women down, just like slide rules were in the 60s, of ruining families.
Big load of things.
Yeah. What?
We're best buddies, is what I'm saying.
Sure.
We did that thing together.
No, no,
buddies.
No, we did not do that thing.
No,
you
asked
and I
so.
Said no, we did not
did
do
so.
That.
We did not. We became blood brothers, okay?
Oh.
Yeah, after you cut your hand, taking that trouble hook, and that scene, I know
yeah, right.
You accidentally snagged.
Right, right. Yeah, that's
what I'm talking about. Of course. And we have the best time. You know, you, me, the guys. Having fun together, laughing, crying, hugging.
Just saying. This game right there, Bobby.
You're a goddamn prank, man.
This stuff's important.
Listen,
to me.
I have right. a wife listening
yeah,
right
she's
now.
She's a goddamn
me.
Whore.
What?
Oh, well, no, not this again. Again. All right, now we're on the air. We're at the boat show. Take good times, man. Big happy thoughts. Outboard motors, dead fish, bullets ripping through flesh.
I'm thinking about that.
Great, great, that's it. So anyhow, listen, Bacon Street is coming at you today from the boat show here in Vice City.
Take my sleep. Don't lose any sleep over there, all right? Just don't worry about it.
again. We met some great folk here at the boat show. Real people, not office folk. I mean, people with hats. A couple of girls with big tits advertising the Canyon Nation bazooka sale. I said to her, hey, you got a license to carry them 44s? Oh, she's good. What?
All right, shut up.
Okay, you hear me? Just shut up, right? I ain't doing this no more. And I mean no more like never. You hear me, Bobby Ray? You hear me? You are acting hysterical. Acting funny? And I don't mean ha-ha funny. I mean funny like you.
All right.
So, say it.
I'm sorry I called your wife Mary Sue. Okay? And those two hookers slots. I'm sorry.
All right, look, at Bobby's good at that sort of thing. I'm going to line broke. I see that bully in the boat. I understand that. Now, he's just letting off some steam. Trying to relax. Sometimes, relaxing can be stressful. It's like when you accidentally hit a bitch.